Guide on documentation for company registration. The company registration is easy when the complete documentation is done in correct manner. In case you have seen our video on the procedure of company incorporation, then you would better appreciate the significance of good documentation for registration of company. The link of the earlier video on the procedure is in the description of this video. To begin with the documentation, we can categorize the documents in three different categories. A. Promoters documents. B. Registered officiated documents. C. Declarations and statutory forms documents. When we refer term promoter, it means the first subscribers to the memorandum of association, which later on is known as shareholder, and all the first directors of the company. With respect to the documents of promoters, on the first part we just need the basic documents. The list of promoters documents are as under. 1. Color photographs. We need 2 front facing picture of each promoter with plain background. 2. PAN card of all the shareholder as well as director is mandatory in case of Indian citizens. However, in case the promoter is a foreigner and if that foreign person or entity has not been allotted a PAN number, then a declaration is sufficient from them. Please note that the name on PAN card must match with the database of Government of India. 3. Identity proof of each promoter. For an Indian promoter, the passport, driving license or voter ID card is considered as ID proof. However, in case of foreign promoter, only passport is considered as ID proof. 4. Every promoter have to submit their latest address proof. Following documents are considered as an address proof if it not older than 2 months. A. Bank statement. B. Updated passbook with first and last bank entry page. C. Electricity bill. D. Telephone bill. Or E. Any utility bill like gas, etc. B. Registered officiated documents. As you must be aware that a private limited company is required to maintain a registered office under Section 12 of the Companies Act 2013. The situation of a registered office has special importance in view of the requirement of the Companies Act to maintain book of account and all statutory registers at the registered office. Very often we receive inquiries. If a company can have its registered office in the co-working space, our answer is simple. In case you get a lockable office space and is open for public inspection without any hindrance, then registered office may be maintained at a co-working space. The virtual office address is completely not acceptable for the purpose of registered office of the company. So, you need to arrange a physical address which shall be registered address of the company. Following are the documents which may be considered as proof of the registered office. 1. Sale deed. 2. Electricity bill. 3. Tax paid receipt or 4. Any other utility bill having address of the premises not older than 2 months. As a property or office can use only with the consent of its owner. Hence, we also need a no objection certificate from the owner of premises. C. Declarations and statutory forms documents. The company gets incorporated by filing prescribed form along with the documents of promoters and the registered address. As per law, the directors and shareholders have to sign many declarations, which is also filed for consideration of the registrar of companies. Once the file application is accepted by the ROC, the certificate of incorporation is issued. That's all for today. In case you need any clarification or have questions on registration of company, feel free to ask them at our dedicated customer care number 9899600605 or email us at help@setindiabiz.com or log into our website www.setindiabiz.com.